Hello everyone, welcome to English with Pranav. In this video we are going to discuss For Anne Gregory. This is a very important poem of class 10th. So if you are a student of class 10th, please watch this video till the end. This will really help you in solving some questions of board examination. For Anne Gregory poem has been composed by a renowned poet who is William Butler Yeats. He also got Nobel Prize for Literature in 1923. And this very poem is very powerful, which will tell you that people should give the value to the inner quality or inner beauty of any person. People should not love any person just on the basis of outward appearance. Anne Gregory is the protagonist of this poem, the main character. Anne Gregory is a very beautiful lady. She has a long honey-colored hair, but she also wants that people should love her on the basis of her inner quality, for herself only, for her inner beauty. People should not love her on the basis of external beauty. This poem is a conversation between a young man and a young woman. What are they arguing about? A young man is none other than the poet here, but in some books it has also been said that another young man is also talking with another young woman, and this young woman is particularly Anne Gregory. Now basically, suppose poet, so never shall, the poet is saying, never shall a young man thrown into despair by those great honey colored ramparts at your ear love you for yourself alone and not your yellow hair. Even the poet is saying that people will never means people will never love you for yourself, for your good qualities and not your yellow hair. People will always give value to your honey colored ramparts. Ramparts are the hair, you can say, which just look like ramparts. Ramparts are just, you can say, what? Walls. The real meaning of ramparts are walls of any castle, palace. So the way walls protect any fort, any castle, in the same way her hair looks like ramparts that protects her ear. Okay, and that looks very beautiful also. That the color of that hair was great honey colored hair. Okay, so the total stanza is basically focusing that even never shall a young man thrown into despair. Despair means, you can say, hopeless, sad. Okay, actually, why will any person become despair? That person will become despair because Anne Gregory rejects those persons who love her for her great honey colored hair. Even Anne Gregory wants that people should love me on the basis of my internal beauty rather than my external beauty. Okay, what is the rhyme scheme of this poem? At first, understand, man is pronounced first type A, despair is different in pronunciation. B, colored is also different in pronunciation. C, ear is despair, air, almost same, it is B. Alone is absolutely different, it is D. Despair, ear, hair, almost same, it is B type. So the rhyme scheme is A, B, C, B, D, B. Dear students, let me tell you, if there are two stanzas, then or three stanzas, then almost the same rhyme scheme will be followed. Her hair is directly compared with ramparts, means walls of fort, so it is called as metaphor. We will discuss some more figures of a speech after the end of this poem. At first, let's understand the second stanza. But I can get a hair dye. Even Anne Gregory is saying that if people will not love me for my inner quality, people will love me for my great honey colored ramparts, great honey colored hair, then I'll get my hair dye and set such color there, like brown or black or carrot color, understood? That young man in despair, that who is, you know, sad, may love me for myself alone. Means she is saying that if I get my hair colored dye in a very normal kind of color, like brown, black or carrot, then people will not love my yellow hair. People will love me for myself alone, for what I am. You know what? All that glitters is not gold. Always remember. Or you should not judge a book by its cover. So here Anne Gregory is also saying that people should love me for myself alone, not my yellow hair. Now the last stanza will be spoken by the poet, who is also focusing on this theme. Please listen. I heard an old religious man but yesternight declare that he had found a text to prove that only God, my dear, could love you for yourself alone and not your yellow hair. Please tell me, dear students, who is the only one who loves you on the basis of your inner quality, inner beauty, and not your external beauty? The answer will be our God. So even God is clearly giving a message to we human beings that appearances can be deceptive. If someone who is looking very beautiful or handsome, it is not sure that she or he will be beautiful from inside also. And if someone is looking normal or ugly or dark complexion, it is not sure that he or she will be bad from inside. Maybe he will be bad, but people should take some time and try to give value to the inner character, inner beauty. I hope till here you have understood. Some basic figures of a speech in the last stanza is bye bye, yellow hair. It is nothing than alliteration. Figures of a speech I have already taught. If you need some extra class for figures of a speech, please comment me. After that, I'll make a video on figures of a speech also. Okay, now please look at some questions and answers right here. That will also help you. What does the young man mean by great honey-colored ramparts at your ears? Why does he say that young men are thrown into despair by them? Please listen. The young man in the poem praises the great honey-colored hair of Anne. Means young men also give value to the outward appearance of Anne Gregory. Anne's hair have been called as ramparts. Always remember. Hana? Rampart meaning as a wall. Ramparts are called as the walls of fort or castle. It is called so because they act as a wall and they protect her ear. Understood? And her hair are so attractive that young men cannot look at anything else. Young men are directly, you can say, attracted by her color. Understood? And his yellow hair are so pretty that young men hopelessly fall in love with her. Means he becomes hopeless. He falls in love with her. But he also thinks that Anne Gregory wants someone to love her on the basis of her inner quality. Understood? So they are hopeless because they know that they will not be successful in gaining her love just on the basis of her external beauty. The next question is, what color is the young bowman's hair? Okay, what does she say she can change it to? Why would she want to do so? Once again, what color is the young woman's hair? Anne's hair are yellowish in color, like the color of honey. Honey you have seen. The next question is, what does she say she can change it to? She says that she can change her hair to black color, brown color, or carrot color. What would she want to do? Why would she want to do so? She wants to do so because she wants other people to love her on the basis of her internal beauty, not on the basis of her external beauty. Now, in internal beauty, what will happen? What will come? In internal beauty, her good nature, her good character, and these all things can come. Next. Objects have qualities which make them desirable to others. Can you think some of? So my dear students, these kinds of questions are very easy. If you read it, you can solve it yourself. The first two questions were very important related to your poem. These are also the humble ones, basic ones. Please solve it. And if you find any problem, do comment me in the comment box. I'll teach it in detail. But I would expect any other topic because this topic I have tried my level best to complete. See you in the next class, my dear students. Please take care. Bye. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.